My name's Robbie Scott. I was the model supervisor on the first Harry Potter film, Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone. I'd like to think I'd make a good wizard, but we've come up with some quite nice things throughout the film without being wizards. Out of all the characters in the Harry Potters, I like Ron. He's an interesting but quiet character. Of all the effects we did, I think I'd love to be able to have a working wand.
Trificus Totas.
The Hogwarts Castle model is the best model I've made. This is the one that stays in my mind. When I saw Hogwarts on film, as we track across the lake and Harry Potter sees it for the first time, was one of the most memorable points in all of the films, I feel. It did make you tingle with pride, and that was going for the whole team as well. Hogwarts is made up of lots of different elements of turrets and towers, spires, bridges, walkways. It's got a lot going on within it. When we first started making the model, we didn't know where the camera was actually going to see at every moment, so we had to make sure that the detail was all over it. It was quite a job to put all those pieces together. It was a daunting task. It's good to see the model now, after all this time here in the studio, and there's lots of detail in it that doesn't really show when you first look at it in the film, but there's lots of texture on the rock faces, lots of texture in the buildings themselves, the tiling, the windows, like we made them so that the windows would reflect like the small panes, so they'd reflect in different ways, little things like that. I like the boathouse. It's small compared with the large size of the overall model, and that's where they arrive, and that's your first point of contact with it. One of my favourite pieces of detail that people wouldn't see is a witch and a cat weather vane. Putting the lighting within the model was quite a job because it meant tunnelling through all of the landscape underneath it. We had a few people who could get in there, not me, I hasten to add, and we tunnelled through it and got the lighting up inside it. The Hogwarts model was one of the last big models used in a blockbuster film that I know of, because computer generation was starting to move in, and our model will probably be the last of its kind, I think. I worked on the Fantastic Beasts series, and it was great to see younger people who had been inspired by what we did on the Harry Potters, and it brought them to the industry, which is great. It really does inspire when you see something you've made inspiring others. I think the reason that people are still enjoying the Harry Potter films is that they're very tangible things, that you just almost sort of reach in and touch the magical side of things, the locations, the story obviously is the major part of that. And I think that story is incredible. You get drawn into it and you enter personally that magical world. Harry Potter and Philosopher's Stone is a very important time in my life. It tested me to see if we could make it as good as it could possibly be. I'd like to think we did that.